Global warming, yes, it's a big matter. It's an important matter. It affects everyone, yes. Climate change, well, lots of things. Medicine, shortage of food, shortage of shelters, all these things, yes. It's affecting the world so much, yeah. And we know, and we can see, unfortunately we can see there are countless of beings around the world who are doing their best, yes, to offer support. And we must rejoice that. Because even though they might not have any knowledge of Dharma, but what they do is they're doing it, I think, genuinely, yeah? Giving whatever they have, yeah? Giving whatever they have to those who have lost their lives, who are going through so much, yes? So, it's just that they don't have the name, or that they're not using the term as Buddhist or Dharma. Otherwise, when those supports comes out of a genuine thought, it is the same. Yeah, so for that, we have to rejoice. And now, we ourselves as Buddhists, yes? Who's supposed to save the world. And when the time comes, we will be there. Yes. if you look at ourselves, we are ever witnessing a lot of things every day. A lot of events that is occurring around the world. Yeah. And we're in a very good vantage point of view, you know, to see everything, what's happening from high to low. And what we can offer as a practitioner, as I always say, is that we have to be an example, yeah? And that's what. An example of peace, an example of patience, of great patience, and example of, you know, really giving support to one another. Yeah. Of course, we can also contribute to all these disasters, whichever we can. It's also good, yes. But from a practitioner's point of view, there's something more than that, yeah? There's something more than that we can offer. Those are temporary support that we can offer, which will help, which will also set very good examples, but on top of it, what we need to have is this Dharma approach, yes? If you do something to them, we don't do it because of my name, for my name, for my wealth, for my satisfaction, no. Yeah, this is what I think quite a difficult challenge, I think, not to do it for one's satisfaction, yeah? Sometimes we feel very compassionate, we wish to do so many wonderful things as a practitioner, and when we can do it, when we can support it, we get the satisfaction, and then we enjoy this, yes? So this is something that we have to be careful. And so then whatever way we can help them, we must, yeah? Long life. Yes, I heard that it's very important to say that. When someone sneezes, okay. When someone sneezes, immediately whoever's around you must say something auspicious, something good. Interesting, huh? And the most interesting thing is that it's there all over the world, in all the cultures. That's quite unique. Yeah, some say bless you. Some say long life, some say other things which I don't know, but yeah. Yeah. It has a purpose, yeah. Which I will not explain now. If you know something, never give it for free, he says. Yeah? Must earn it. With hard meditation and practice. Lots of sleepless nights of studying. Anyway, Yes, so as a practitioner, we can really offer a lot. We can do the same thing that the world is doing, but the best gift is not to do it out of pride, but to do it with genuine compassion. Yes, if you do that, then it is the best offering that you can that you ever offer. You could be just simply offering one handful of, let's say, dust or earth, yeah, which doesn't even belong to you, but you just offer it to them, yes, out of compassion, out of that attitude, understanding. If you give it, it's that handful of earth is far more priceless than anything, yeah. And it has great merit. Yeah. Even though that is also one thing. Doesn't necessarily. It's possible that the receiver might not appreciate. Also, yeah, doesn't matter. The fact is, you did. Yes. Yeah, that's what it counts. So if you do all that, then the fourth will naturally come. The nirvana is peace. Yeah. Then it will definitely obtain nirvana. So let's dedicate our merit to all sentient beings. Yes, one thing that we have to also keep in mind, I'm sure you all of you do, is that to think of mainly of all the deceased, yeah, all over the world, all over the universe, all over samsara, yeah, those who are experiencing the transition, let's say. Yes, for most of them it's very, very hard. They don't know what's going on, and they go through all kinds of chaos and difficulties. So it's very important that we think of them and dedicate our merits to them. Yes, this is very, very important. So on account, like normally, averagely, I guess nowadays, although there are so many new let's say, there are so many newborns in this world, on top of the 8 billion. Still, also there are around, I think, 250 or 300,000 that also leaves, yeah? So that's how much is happening. So that is just the count of human beings, yeah? We're not even thinking of the ants and others, you know? Yeah. Like, every day, like, from minute to minute, they're leaving, so must think of all of that, and for their happiness, for their way out, for their freedom, and for their enlightenment, then a good rebirth, we dedicate our merit, yeah? Sonam di tamje zimba nye tomne nyebe danam pamje ne jega nanje balam trubaye sebe sole rova dolvara shoo.